right, you guys. So we have our M&Ms, our chocolate Chex, our pretzels, our pumpkin spice Cheerios. Yes, I said that right. And then our pumpkin marshmallows. Now I'm gonna go ahead and melt up my milk chocolate. I'm using the Ghirardelli, but you can use whatever chocolate you prefer, dark or white. I'm just gonna microwave this for 30 second increments. All right, we got that nice and melted. Now we're gonna go ahead and do a drizzle on top of all of these yummy snacks. This is gonna be the best Halloween fall time snack you've ever had. It's all the best cereals and candies you could ever ask for. I've yet to try those pumpkin spice marshmallows or Cheerios, so I'm very excited. Of course, we wanna get all of that chocolate out, so let's just grab our spatula. It's okay if we get big chunks of it coming out. We will make sure everything looks incredible. Okay, get all out. Yummy, beautiful. All right, now for the fun part, we're gonna take our spatula and just mix everything together. We want everything to have a nice little chocolate drizzle on them. We want everything to be mixed like a Chex mix, because that's kind of what we're making here. We're kind of making a dessert Halloween Chex mix with all these fun flavors, pumpkin spice, chocolate. Oh yeah, the salty pretzels. I am gonna be eating this all month long. This is great for, you know, taking to a kid's school Halloween party because it has all these goodness. I didn't use anything with nuts, so hopefully there's no allergy issues. Oh yeah, look at that beauty. Now to add that festive color, I have these little baby black and orange sprinkles. And we're just gonna go ham with these. Obviously these are optional. I just really wanted that Halloween color to stand out, so I opted for them. Ooh, they are wanting to go everywhere, but you know what? The more the better. Okay, just a little bit more. I don't want to be skimpy with the sprinkles. This is what's really gonna make this festive. Beautiful. All right, you guys, we're gonna pop this in the fridge for an hour and then it's gonna be ready to eat. All right, you guys. It was actually only in the fridge for like 15 minutes, but it already seems like the chocolate hardened up a little bit. Oh yeah. Okay, so we're just gonna go ahead and kind of break it apart just a little bit because we don't want too big of clusters. We definitely want it to be more of like a Chex mix. Watch out for those sprinkles. They are bouncy. Okay, but once we get them a little bit taken off that sheet pan, you could obviously use parchment paper for this, but it is not exactly necessary. Okay. So I'm just gonna go ahead and serve up some clusters because that's how I like to eat these. Just spoon it right on your plate for people to enjoy, maybe even a bowl, whatever you want to do it. I haven't gotten my Halloween, you know, kitchenware out, but I think a cute little Halloween bowl would be super adorable. All right, it's time to try this. It looks so good. All my favorite things in one bite. That is so good.